गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन टेंडर्स अंडर मॉड्यूल 4. टेंडर. द टेंडर इज एन ऑफर इन राइटिंग टू एग्जीक्यूट सम स्पेसिफाइड वर्क और टू सप्लाई द मटेरियल्स एट सर्टेन रेट्स विद इन ए फिक्स्ड टाइम अंडर द सर्टेन कंडीशन ऑफ अग्रीमेंट बिटवीन द कॉन्ट्रैक्टर एंड द डिपार्टमेंट और ओनर और एनी पार्टी. When a lot of contractors are expected to quote, sealed tenders in a prescribed form are invited from the approved list of contractors. Necessity of tenders. To check willingness of the contractor to carry out the work. Second one, to get reasonable offer from the contractor within the estimated cost. Third one, to complete the work in time. Fourth one, to use expertise and resources of the contractor. Next one, earnest money deposit. When the contractor submits the tenders for a work, he has to deposit some amount, usually at about 2% of the estimated cost, to the department as a guarantee of the tender. If the contractor refuses to take up the work, when his tender accepted, his earnest money is forfeited. But the earnest money of all other contractors whose tenders have not been accepted will be returned to the respective contractors. The earnest money may be in cash or fixed deposit in bank, cash certificate, bank guarantee like saving certificate, etc. Security deposit. Once the tender is accepted, the selected contractor should deposit 10% of the total cost of work as security deposit with the department. This amount includes the earnest money of already deposited. The contractor may deposit the entire amount at the beginning of the work, or it may be deducted from the running bill of the contractor. The contractor should fulfill conditions of the contract and carry out work satisfactorily according to the specification and completes the work in time. Tender notice. After the tender documents have been prepared and approved by the authority, a notice inviting the tender has to be published on the notice board of all unit of offices of the department. For work of greater magnitude, wide publicity should be given to the notice inviting the tenders. Tender must be invited in the most open and transparent manner possible, by advertisement in the press and by notice in English or Hindi and the written language of the district, posted in public place. Here is the sample tender notice for the various authorities. There are following particulars are written in the tender notice. The first one, name of the authority inviting the tenders. Second, name of the work and its locations. Third one, estimated cost of the work. Fourth one, period of contract and type of contract. Fifth one, place and date the tender document should be purchased. Sixth one, the amount to be paid for the set of tender document. Seventh one, last date and time of submission of tenders. Eighth one, the amount of earnest money that should be deposited along with the tender and the amount of security deposit to be paid by the selected contractor. Ninth one, date and time of opening the tender. Tenth one, the designation of the officer who accept the tender. These are the included in tender notice. Next one, receiving, opening, scrutiny and acceptance of tenders. First one, receiving of tenders. After issues of tender documents to contractor, the tender opening authority authorized an officer to receiving the tender, and tender may be sent either by post or email or can put in the tender box kept for the purpose in the premises of the owner. Tender placed in the tender box is locked and kept under the safe custody of the officer. The closing time of the receipt of tender should be kept after the normal times of delivery of the post. The tender received after the due date and times are rejected. Opening of tenders. The sealed tenders are received which are opened in the presence of the contractor or their representative tendering for the work at the time and place already noticed. The officer opening the tender has to be read out the rates offered in case of item rate and percentage rate tenders and amount in case of lump sum tenders for information of all those present. All the tenders will be serially numbered and signed by the officer opening the tender. Preparing comparative statement of tenders. After the tenders are opened, a comparative statement is made in the office of the tender opening authority. It serves to compare the rates of the various tenders in respect of each item against the estimated rates. The excess of or savings for each tender is worked out. A mistake in it may lead to the work being awarded a contractor who is not lowest. Scrutiny of tenders. After preparing comparative statement, the tender opening authority shall verify whether the contractor has agreed to all the tender conditions or he has included any special conditions and the consequent variation in the total amount has to be calculated. If the acceptance of a particular tender does not rest with the divisional officer, he has to forward to the tender along with the comparative statement and tender document with his recommendation or observation to the next higher authority for consideration. Acceptance of tenders. Here it includes title page, index page, based upon the comparative statement. Usually the lowest tender is accepted except in the case where the work of the contractor who has quoted the lowest rate has not been satisfactory on previous occasion or there is doubt. Then completion certificate. When the work is completed and the accounts have been selected, in a note below the final entries is made in red ink, were completed on following dates, and this note is signed by the division officer. If the total expenditure is excess of sanctioned estimate and the excess is passed by the division officer under his power, excess passed by me should be added to the completion note. This completion report is forwarded by division officer to the auditing officer. After verification by auditing officer, it is transferred to superintending engineer who will sanction the excess expenditure. Thank you.